say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drip, can't catch my wave. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your veins? Though you may get all that you desire, don't see it when that never be the same. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your, right through your veins? Though you may get all that you desire, don't see
it. EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New Orleans Saints and the Carolina Panthers. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Ball carrier.
Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10.
2 yard line.
Love from the gun. That's to McCaffrey, complete. Fights off the defender and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On 2nd down, McCaffrey. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. A pretty decent game.
47-yard line.
A couple of 1st downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on 1st down. Now Love winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And that is incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
They throw again on 2nd down. This one's complete. And he's got this down to the 35. The catch and run, good for 18 and a 1st down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. On 1st down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
34-yard line.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run. Let's get off the field, D.
Love now on 2nd down. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 20-yard line. A bit of a catch for him to remember. That's number 400 for his NFL career. Not a bad number at all. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
21-yard line.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a third and one.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
So play number 10 now coming. It's been a long opening drive, but this is third down. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Had a chance to maybe limit them to three if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing, right? And everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defenses just say, okay, new set of downs. It gives us another chance to make a play ourselves and maybe change things up.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door. First and goal. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. This will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
The score, Panthers 7, Saints nothing.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And we will not see a run back here from Harris.
At their own 25-yard line.
First down gets three up to the 28.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Here's Eason to throw, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. From the gun is Eason. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
Normally, you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Fielded just inside the 30. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. It all came together. But I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Working out of the gun. Love. Looking for the out route, and he's got more. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
A 3 yard pickup brings up second and seven at the Saints 35 yard line.
Now a run with McCaffrey. And good running, going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 30. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards. But also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Fourth down after the New Orleans defense holds serve.
Coverage was awfully tight there on third down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Joey Sly on now for the Panthers. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a 47-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. And the lead moves to 10-0. So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coach is always talking about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense, right?
But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, picked off at the 35, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week, he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19. That catch good for only a couple.
At the 19-yard line. That's the end of the first quarter with the score Panthers 10, Saints nothing.
Second and eight coming from the 19. To throw now, here's Love. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. Open man is Samuel, complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
So things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
Operating from the gun, Love. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
It's good.
And he puts it through.
The score, Panthers 17. Saints.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And no return on this one as the fair catch. Signal four and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Eason going to throw it out of the shotgun. He gets this one complete to Traquan Smith. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It's a big play, yet amazingly, because of how far they had to go, they're still looking at a second down here.
Brings up second down at the 34-yard line.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field, and I don't think he got there. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. On first down, this is McCaffrey. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short.
Now that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block, but the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes, so when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
Flushed out right. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Here's Love. That's to his running back, complete. And eventually taken down, but how about that athletic spin move we saw? Gives him the first down yardage. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. 2 yard line. On first and 10, Love. That's Samuel, caught left side. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Love now to pass on first down. Flush to his right. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And this is picked up by the Saints. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. You think about it, Charles, this is not a quarterback that's used to running the football a lot, and that time he was loose with it, had it knocked free.
He always has to think to himself that there's always going to be traffic around because of what you just said. Not that elusive, not going to get into the open field very often. Remember, he's not Lamar Jackson, not Michael Vick back in the day. Always has to protect the football because there's always going to be people around.
Following the fumble recovery, Eason. He'll find its tight end. It's Adam Trautman. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 17 yards on the play as they try to eat into this 17-point deficit.
First down.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. From the gun, Eason. He's going to float this over the middle, deep. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Throwing again, Eason. Looking for Thomas, but that's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Number 22.
A gain of three, second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The last run got three, now here's second and seven. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets them up now first and goal.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Operating from the gun, Love. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And this is picked up by the Saints. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He already had the one fumble lost, so now two fumbles lost here in this first half.
Not setting the pace the way that you want it done. I mean, here in the first half, already twice the ball's come out and hit the turf. Gotta find a way to take care of it. Otherwise, they may have to start thinking about maybe someone different in that position.
A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Second and seven at the 20-yard line.
Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 11 yards there. First down.
A gain of 11 on the play.
From the gun, Eason. Over the middle to Smith. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and two. At the 39-yard line.
Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Operating from the gun, Eason. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As this old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. And they'll run the option on third and short yardage. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special runs in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 23 yards on the play.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making it a change.
And this is going to be intercepted. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And what a return as he brings this one all the way back to the 25-yard line.
All right, let's go ahead and just add it up here. Their last three drives, two fumbles, and an interception. Somewhere, to paraphrase one of the great coaches of the NFL, they're asking on that sideline, what the heck is going on out there?
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here, getting 3 points.
And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans.
Touchdown.
Traquan Smith, his first touchdown on the year. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. And his kick is right through.
17. Saints seven.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Get the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
On second down, Love once more. And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. From the gun. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one hears away. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of five, and the Saints will take over with a first down and 10.
At their own 18-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get enough.
And he's taken down. Back at his own seven. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Well, they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. From the gun, Eason. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Operating from the gun, Eason. He's going to wind up and air it out. And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
At their own 44-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw again. Love. Steps away to his left. Looking left side. Andrews with it complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Play fake. Here's Love. That's going to be caught. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And they're able to up the lead by one more.
This is for Panthers 24, Saints 7. Joey Sly to kick off.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And incomplete, as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. Back to the air on second down. Eason looking again for Thomas, this time complete. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. First and 10, Eason gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number three. And we will not see a run back here from Harris. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Terrific running there to start the drive, as that's going to go for 15 and a quick first down as well.
Tackled at the 40-yard line. A gain of 15.
They'll throw on first down with Eason. He's got a man that's caught left sideline.
Eason's pass.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
A gain of 16.
Now they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Got position on him, and he pulls it in. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. From the gun, Eason, and he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That catch good for only a couple. Here's a four-receiver look now. Three of those guys out to the right side on second and eight. Open man is the tight end, Troutman. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adam Troutman, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints get a bit closer.
The kick is good.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This now a 10-point game, so things tightening a little bit after that last score. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
And this is just a little touch pass. It's in the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward to it. Now, it doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down. A nice, consistent game.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time.
McCaffrey on the carry.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Operating from the gun, Love. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
On third down, Love got his target, Samuel. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 16 yards, a little deja vu from the previous play where they got 16.
First down. First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
McCaffrey. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he had to get this down to the 15. He won't make it. He's a yard or two short. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up the fourth down. And no signs of the field goal unit. They're going for it on fourth down. They'll run for it. McCaffrey. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. To pass, here's Jordan Love. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead. The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
On first down, Jacob Eason. Pressure comes in, he's brought down, it's a Panther sack. Derrick Brown, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
It's second down.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. From the gun is Eason. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Tay Jackson picks it.
Let's go! Come on!
The second down pass intercepted. The Panthers take over first and 10 at the 26-yard line.
And they'll begin by running the option. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Now a second down throw for Love here. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Third and long for Love. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
So a good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coach is always talking about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious.
And my goodness, another interception. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call, so that one will be accepted.
To kick off for Carolina.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Interception. Eason. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. And we're back now in Charlotte. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Escaping the pressure right. And incomplete on the deep ball.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this when I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
To go.
The Saints on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is third and 10. Eason going to throw it out of the shotgun. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again. Eason. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
A gain of 19 yards.
On first and 10, Eason. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. That catch good for only a couple. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now a dump off here complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 23. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
First down, New Orleans.
Throwing on first down, Eason. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Saints.
From the gun, Eason, looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know, what do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now.
He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Yetur Gross-Matos. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. The Saints on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 19. Operating from the gun, Eason. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They get 20 yards there on 3rd and 19, and an unlikely first down. From the gun, Eason. Flushed out right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
An incomplete pass on first down. Here's 2nd and goal. Operating from the gun, Eason. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Yetur Gross-Matos able to record his 5th sack of the season.
Third down and goal.
3rd and goal. Try to make that scoreboard at least a little more respectable. From the gun, Eason. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Adam Trautman, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. And it's up and good.
Score, Panthers 41, Saints 21.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They're looking at a 3rd straight win here if they can hold on. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. Space to maneuver at the 40. And all the way up to the 45-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones at a first down.
At carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the 4th quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
58, come on. 58, come on.
This is McCaffrey. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Credit to tackle that time to Deshaun Hand. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now a first carry for their fullback.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The Panthers on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and four. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning, and we'll be back.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He's down inside the 10 to the 8, and it comes on a gain of 8. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
Again, they run again. It's McCaffrey. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. The Panthers on third down. Not quite 50%. 4 for 9. This time it's third and 3. He may try and run, and he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Jordan Love keeping it himself from 10 yards away. And the Panthers add on to their lead. The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
On first down, Eason. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Another incomplete pass there. What do you take from this game offensively?
Well, you know it's tough to really analyze for them because it is a team game, right? Let's be honest, though. The defense did them no favors in this one at all. Offense actually moved the ball. So, bottom line, film session, defense is going to be a real tough one for them. Offense, they'll get a little bit of praise.
He was trying to get that ball to Auden Tate,
and it's third down.
And 10 yards to go.
Operating from the gun, Eason. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down.
First down.
And he will find his man on the outside. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Adam Troutman.
It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13.
First down, New Orleans.
From the gun, Eason. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for him. And after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 23. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. On first and 10, Eason. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Brings up second and 2 at the 15.
Operating from the gun, Eason. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. He had to absorb another little bump there from the defense, another incomplete pass. We've seen a lot of that tonight.
They've come after him all night long. Nothing but pressure in his face. He's trying to stand up there and make throws. It's hard enough to do when the pocket is clear. When you got all those people in front of you, almost impossible to have a good completion percentage.
And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. From the gun, Eason looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. Eason on second down to the end zone, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. But now it's third and goal.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged 2 pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've got to run out of your running play.
And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's